Hi, this is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. A few years ago, I did a tutorial showing how to create the look of a wood brand. I've updated it, making it more streamlined and easier. I provided this wood texture that you can download so you can follow along. Its link is in my video's description or project files below. Open a black and white image. If you'd like to add text to it, open your type tool, pick a font, adjust its size, and make sure the color is black. Type out your text. To reposition it, open your move tool and move it. Press Ctrl or Command E to merge the layers. For my example, I'll just use this design without text. To place it onto the wood texture, press Ctrl or Command A to select it, and Ctrl or Command C to copy it. Click the tab of the wood texture. Press Ctrl or Command V to paste your image onto the wood. To resize it, open your Transform tool by pressing Ctrl or Command T. Go to a corner, and when you see a diagonal double arrow, press Alt or Option plus Shift as you drag it in or out. Then press Enter or Return. Make a copy of the layer by pressing Ctrl or Command J. Hide the copy and make the original layer active. Open the Channels panel. If you don't see it, go to Window and Channels. Click the circular icon at the bottom to make a selection of the black shapes. Open back your Layers panel and press the Delete key on your keyboard to delete the white background. Make the top layer visible and active. Invert the selection by pressing Ctrl or Command Shift I. Go to Select, Modify, and Expand. Expand it 1 pixel and click OK or press Enter or Return. We'll fill the selection with black, but first, if your foreground and background colors aren't black and white respectively, press D on your keyboard. Since black is your foreground color, press Alt or Option plus Delete. To deselect it, press Ctrl or Command D. Invert the layer by pressing Ctrl or Command I. Go to Filter, Stylize, and Wind. The method is Wind. For now, it doesn't matter which direction is ticked. Click OK or press Enter or Return. We'll repeat the filter twice by pressing Ctrl or Command F twice. Go back to Filter, Stylize, and Wind. This time, tick the other direction and click OK or press Enter or Return. As before, press Ctrl or Command F twice. Invert the layer and go to Filter, Blur, and Gaussian Blur. Blur it 1 pixel. Open your Levels window by pressing Ctrl or Command L and make the output black level 72. Hide layer 1 and change the Active Layers Blend Mode to Color Burn. Reduce its opacity to 60%. Control-click or Command-click the thumbnail of layer 1 to make a selection of your design. Click the New Layer icon to make a new layer. Go to Select, Modify, and Feather. Feather the selection 2 pixels. Fill it with black and deselect it. Reduce the fill to 40%. Doing this reduces the opacity of the layer, but it'll retain the full visibility of the layer style effects that we're going to add to it. Double-click an empty area of the active layer to open the layer style window. Click Bevel and Emboss. The style is outer bevel. The technique is smooth. The depth is 50%. The direction is up. The size is 20 pixels. And the soften is 0. Uncheck Global Light. The angle is 130 degrees. The altitude is 48 degrees. And the gloss contour is linear. The highlight mode and the color don't matter because the opacity is 0%. The shadow mode is linear burn, the color is black, and the opacity is 22%. Click Inner Shadow. The blend mode is linear burn, the color is black, and the opacity is 10%. Uncheck Global Light. The angle is 147 degrees. The distance is 5 pixels. The choke is 0%. And the size is 50 pixels. Then click OK. This is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. Thanks for watching.